Hey fellow Levites, how's it going? It's Levi here from Leviathan Gaming. This week, the game I'm playing is Left 4 Dead 2, but I've modded it with the help of the Steam Workshop to make it as cursed as possible, so I hope you guys enjoy that. While that's going on, in the background, I would like to talk to you about something I have seen personally plague the gaming community for years. Whether I'm playing online, streaming over Twitch, or even playing a board game like Magic the Gathering at my local game store. This plague is the way most people, but especially gamers, tend to see their own value in the eyes of the world. And trust me, as a gamer myself, I know how I used to see my own worth, and it sucked. This is because I have this problem that almost everybody struggles with but fails to admit, where I think I'm better than everybody, but at the same time, I feel like I'm unworthy of being loved. It feels really weird. Thankfully, as time went on, I began to understand and realize that I'm actually exactly where I need to be at this point in my life. And while I continue to become the best version of myself, I need to realize myself that while I may not be the best, there's nobody else in the world like me who can bring exactly everything else that I bring to the table. So the idea of this plague, however you want to see it, is in my opinion an obstacle that needs to be overcome in order to obtain some sort of peace in this lifetime. Something to realize is that getting to a point where you're truly at peace with yourself and feel happy and content is not an easy thing to actually achieve. I would go so far as to say that it would be one of the hardest undertakings that anybody can undertake in their entire life. And I understand that after hearing this, you may not want to go after it, and most people might actually say no. However, I can personally guarantee you that if you give this your all, if you give this 110%, I guarantee you personal peace and joy, not only in this life, but also in the next. The first step, while kind of hard to understand, is to realize that while yes, you do have importance and you do have value, you actually deserve nothing. This is simply because life, the person of life, doesn't choose favorites. And choose is a word that sometimes doesn't even exist. We're never given a choice sometimes. And that might seem unfair, but I mean, it's real, and there's plenty of examples of this. Take how each day, millions of people are born into this world, but they have no control over the circumstances they are born into. Some are aborted, some are born into poverty, some are orphaned, and some are born into royalty with millions of dollars. The lesson to be taken from this is that sometimes life is hard. Reality is there's no easy way out. Nothing ever came easily to anybody. Even if you have millions of dollars, in an instant, you could be living on the streets or someone close to you who you love and care about could die. And yes, obviously, when loss does happen, you should take your time to mourn it and process what has happened. But you must also remember that when a wall does appear in front of you, you should try your hardest to get to the other side. Whether you have to dig, climb, hike around it, do whatever you have to get to the other end. And the good thing is, this metaphorical wall actually applies to anything. Whether it's toxic people and relationships in your life, whether it's a job that you're struggling with, whether it's having a hard time in school, anxiety, depression. God gives us tools that we can use to advance and get around these walls, whether it be help of a parent, help of friends, somebody on YouTube, whatever. God gives us these tools. Perhaps one of my biggest issues with society today is that people are raised to believe that there's this man, right? The man. That there's the man in power who's trying to overcome you and push you down and keep your head shoved down below and keep you from excelling in life. And that there's nothing you can do about it. There's nothing you can work on. There's nothing you can overcome because of this person holding you back. Almost like a glass wall or a glass ceiling that you cannot see. To this, I say, don't fall into that victim mindset. Reality is in front of you, and that reality shows that with Satan in the world, everybody's a victim. Every single person in the world is struggling in a different way, shape, or form, but there's nobody that is completely just filled with a blessed life that doesn't have any struggle in it whatsoever. That is non-existent. Realizing that this is reality, you need to personally take it upon yourself to stop moping about like sin hasn't already been conquered and you will never accomplish anything. Because the beautiful thing about this life, right, this life that we live, is that almost 2,000 years ago, God came down from heaven as a man, spent 3 years traveling, spreading great news that he is back and he is alive and he is real. And then he took it upon himself to die for our sins. He died for you. He died for me. He died for Martin Luther King. Heck, he even died for Adolf Hitler. He doesn't care who you are. He died for you because he loves you. And the church even teaches that in those moments leading up to his death, he saw our whole life, right? He saw each individual one of us. He saw our entire lives. And he saw the good. He saw the bad. He saw the beautiful. He saw the ugly. He saw you getting food poisoning that one night and it was a mess. And he saw what that was like. And he still loved you. And he saw you that time that you paid for groceries for somebody at the grocery store who couldn't afford their food. And he paid for that time that you beat up your little brother and made him cry, even though it was over the stupidest thing ever. He saw everything. And though you may not feel like he is there with you. In those times when it feels like he's gone, it's because he's so close to you that you were blinded by his light. You go through nothing alone in this life. Every trial, every pain, every suffering, every obstacle, every wall, Jesus is with you, and you need to remember that. You cannot forget that. Whether you see it or not, whether you believe in him, whether you refuse to see his existence, whether you believe in another God, no matter what it is, he's still there with you. So remember these two things. First, that you have to be proactive in life. Seek advice. Learn. Use the tools that God puts around you to overcome your obstacles and conquer your walls. But then, on top of that, remember that not only has God given you these tools, but God has experienced suffering and he is there with you. He is pursuing you. He is constantly next to you, helping you make it through these struggles. All right, finally to close, I want to close with a question, okay? After this, I want you to take 5 to 10 minutes to pray to yourself and pray to God for strength to make it through whatever struggle you're going right now, whether it's anxiety, depression, girl problems, guy problems, relationship drama with friends, whatever it is, family issues. Pray to God for the strength to make it through that and find some tools that you can do to conquer or at least work towards conquering these issues. And ask yourself the question, if you have the God of the entire universe on your side, what can hold you back? All right, guys, that's pretty much it. I thank you for this time. Enjoy the rest of the video. Take that time to pray and have a wonderful day. God bless. I'll be praying for you.